Hi, I'm Owen Canfield with the opinion page of The Oklahoman, here to talk about life at the Capitol with Mike McNutt, our chief Capitol correspondent. Mike, thank you for being here.
You bet.
I grabbed today's Friday paper. Tough couple of stories that made the news, both written by Michael McNutt. One of them, Oklahoma House won't take up the personhood bill. And the other one, fetal heartbeat bill, is now on its way to the governor. So social issues at the fore. Result was a win, I guess you'd say, for one, and a loss for the other. Sum up, if you would, sort of the tone and the content, if you can, of these two bills and how they can, you know.
Well, personhood bill is, you know, very emotional.
Yes.
This is the one bill that the Senate took up early in the session, and there's a protest against it.
Right.
Many people probably remember there were about 200 women right. outside the Capitol, and a state senator carried a sign that made national headlines. But it basically says, the bill itself is trying to say, the state of Oklahoma believes that life begins at conception.
Right.
Now, what does that mean?
Right, exactly.
Well, and so
and that became the problem.
That became the problem. Opponents think that this could be the beginning step or could be enough to outlaw birth control, abortion, in vitro fertilization,
and research and all these things, right.
And we also, at the same time, a personhood bill, which is, there's a national group called Personhood Act Group right. USA, they've started, there was a bill filed, now there's the initiative petition, and it does outlaw, specifically right. says we're going to outlaw abortion, we're going to outlaw birth control, we're going to outlaw.
So there's a chance this could be decided at the polls.
Right. But I think it got kind of messed
right.
up a little bit,
right.
confused a little. But basically, it was, why do you need a personhood bill?
Right.
You know, not a resolution, which just basically states the state's intent. Lots of talk about it. The backers were concerned that the House wasn't going to hear it.
Right.
They tried to find a way to get it brought out in the open. So the House Republicans, who have control of the House, held a caucus meeting Thursday.
Right.
Basically took a straw poll, and they said, no, we don't want to hear it.
And that's that.
It's basically that, because there's another similar bill that was filed last year, and it's a House bill that the House did pass. It's somewhere in the Senate. But if the House is Republican, not going to take up this bill, it's not going to take up another
sure.
bill.
So now, the other issue, though, about fetal heartbeat monitor required right. now for a woman seeking an abortion is headed to the governor's desk. That raised some hackles in the House yesterday as well during debate, didn't it?
Yeah, it was a question of whether it's necessary.
Right.
We had a couple of representatives say it's already in the informed consent law.
That's already on the books.
It's already in the books that requires an ultrasound image, and the woman should be hearing the heartbeat of the child.
Right.
Now, the backers of the bill say this specifically says a woman who's at least 8 months, 8 weeks pregnant, should it's up to the abortion provider to ask the woman to hear the heartbeat
right.
instead of the woman asking to make sure. So anyway, it did provoke a lot of emotions again. We had a strong supporter, even pro-life backers are saying, don't push us too far. How
right.
far do you want to go?
Well, Governor Fallon will make the ultimate call. I will say this, when Doug Cox, Representative Doug Cox of Grove, who's a solid Republican, stands up and says, you're about to drive me to the other side with these kind of bills, it's something Republicans need to think about there at the Capitol. So I invite you to read Mike's stuff every day in the newspaper and here on News OK, and we appreciate you joining us today.